Siren Audio Studios proudly presents Van Choc Straw. Adapted from the stage play Van Choc Straw, written by Mark Dunn and adapted for audio cinema by Mark Dunn. The year is 2001. The story is set somewhere in the suburban American South.
Wow.
Do you like it?
It's larger than I thought it would be. And I like the whole spooky Halloween vibe.
Halloween vibe?
Yeah, all the cobwebs and everything.
Cobwebs are real, honey. I don't come down here very often.
When was the last time you got down here?
That terrible storm last spring, I think. I was worried about the possibility of flooding.
And was there?
Dry as a bone. My neighbors weren't so fortunate. Oh, the things you can learn from nature's fury. Cat boxes float. Snooker tables do not.
The room, it does look kind of, you know, entombed.
Is that a good assessment, dear, or a bad one?
Just an observation.
This was my son's room. Well, it was my husband's to begin with, but Colin took it over. He was mad about table tennis. You must never call it ping pong, not around him. He was a stickler about this. He was very good. He won the city championship 2 years in a row.
Where is he now?
Colin lives in San Jose. I get cards. Oh, watch the dust there.
I could turn this into an office.
Oh, you don't want an office down here. There aren't any windows. You should put your office upstairs in the little room off the landing. It has a southern exposure. You can sit and feel the warmth of the morning sun right there at your desk.
That room just might have to be a nursery.
Oh, you have a baby.
Not yet. We're expecting.
How far along is she due?
About 20 hours past the home pregnancy test. She was going to take another one tonight, just to be sure.
A baby. That's wonderful.
We've been trying for 5 years.
Oh, dear. A lot of people would have given up by now.
Connie wants a baby come hell or high water. Well, I do, too. You were really kind to show me around. I mean, without the real estate agent.
Oh, wasn't she impertinent? I was so glad when she left. She told me not to mention any of the house's shortcomings. Goodness, every house has shortcomings. An honest seller makes for a happy buyer, I always say.
I should probably be getting home.
It was so nice to meet you.
I'll bring Connie on the weekend if you're going to be around.
I'm afraid I'll be gone by then, dear. In fact, my sister, Ina, she's coming to pick me up tomorrow. Ina and all those movers. It's going to be bedlam around here.
You're moving in with your sister?
That's right. Which means most of this stuff is going right into storage. I'll just be getting the one room, you see. It used to be a sewing room. It will feel like a closet. I'm not complaining. The room has a southern exposure. But it was a challenge, believe me, deciding what to take, what not to take. I know now what those nursing home residents, what they must go through, paring down from a lifetime of acquisitions to what will fit into 2 or 3 suitcases.
You don't seem all that happy about moving.
Well, I'm not, dear. But I don't have much choice in the matter. I shouldn't be living alone. My health has betrayed me with a vengeance.
I'm sorry to hear that.
What do you do, dear, for a living? If you told me, I'm afraid I've forgotten.
I work for WZPG, in the advertising department.
Oh, I'm always listening to that station, mostly at night. Sometimes all night long. It's a strange assortment of people who call those shows in the middle of the night. They have theories.
A lot of real wackos. You're right about that.
And a few insomniacs. And then, of course, there are a few folks who just listen for the company, don't they?
That's true.
The voices can be a comfort, you know. The quiet. That late-night quiet. Well, it can wear on you after a while.
I suppose it can.
Well, you go on home to your wife. Do you like the house?
It's a great house.
You can say it's not for you. I won't mind, really. Some people object to the bay window.
The bay window is a nice feature.
They say it looks, what was it that one fellow called it? Imposed. He said my bay window looked imposed. He preferred one more organic.
I'm not sure what that means.
I think it means he didn't like the house. But someone will come along who'll appreciate it. Someone who likes a house with a certain lived-in quality. Don't you get that feeling? That lived-in feeling? It's like buying pre-washed jeans, isn't it?
You could say that. Look at all those puzzles. Your family must have really liked jigsaw puzzles.
Oh, it was a weekend ritual, for a while at least. Then read. That was my.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.